Hello and welcome to episode 9 of my trophy guide for Monster Hunter World and Monster Hunter World Iceborne. Go through all the dialogue, speak with the handler, and take on the final assignment of Monster Hunter World, Land of Convergence.
Impressive! What's wrong? Understood.
Hey, partner! Are you sure you want to go on that quest from the Admiral?
Ha! Full steam ahead!
How wonderful!
Pick up some stones, talk to the seeker twice, and agree to board the boat.
So, you made it.
Admiral! Whoa! The seeker is here too!
Greetings. Farewell. Now then. It begins.
Before even drawing our weapon, we can lure this monster around the arena and drop 4 boulders on it for a total of over 3000 damage. This monster can be quite tricky to fight because of its size. You can try going for its head and deal the most amount of damage, but I recommend attacking the forelimbs if you feel less confident. Stay vigilant, as its moves have a lot of reach and never stand underneath it.
Yeah.
In phase 2, we will take it slow. Its laser beams will now set the ground on fire. Do not step on the burning surface, as your health will get chipped down. It might not seem like a lot, but you will burn through your potions very quickly. Its attacks are powerful, but as long as you don't rush it, this fight won't be too difficult.
Thank you.
After the credits, you will obtain the final story trophy of the base game, the Sapphire Star. All the remaining trophies of the base game overlap with the expansion, so we will go and dive into Monster Hunter World Iceborne right away. But first, we want to delete every single investigation to ensure we have enough space for mass rank investigations. You can do that by pressing the Options button. Talk to the feisty fiver and follow me to the cutscene.
Yo! Ready to go? Yeah, let's do this!
There's a Legiana in the ancient forest and nobody knows why. I rounded up all the eyewitness data available. Follow me! Legiana tracks. No mistake, it's really here. Does the forest seem off to you today? Let's keep going. It feels a little weird now that the Elder Crossing investigation's done. It's exciting too, though. I wonder what comes next. It's so quiet. What gives? I haven't seen so much as a bug. Where are the birds? Maybe something's got them all spooked? Those tracks were headed west, partner. Wonder if the next investigation is gonna be super long, too. I know I plan to stay here for at least another decade. They say the Elder Crossings happen once every 10 years, right? We can't really call our investigation complete if we don't stick around to
Now that everyone's here, as such, I'm sure, Director.
Gladly. Why, they've either some
or beyond this.
Commando?
Ha!
It's not j-
Good.
Oh, no.
Commander, sir. Like a new.
So.
Something.
Yes, that settles it. I'll need Han and you two. We may not. Good luck, everyone. And may the Sapphire Star light your way. All right, then. Dismissed.
Take a meal and retrieve some nullberries. Take note that from now on you can equip 2 specialized tools at once, so do make use of that. Speak to the commander twice, then agree to board the airship.
Okay. Well, off you go. Okay. Get going.
Oh, look at all this snow. And it's freezing. We can't stay out in this cold. Let's set up camp before we freeze to death. We can change into something warmer while we're at it. The commander procured some cold weather gear for us.
Upon our arrival at the next locale, we obtain and are forced to put on a layered armor set. This is solely cosmetical and does not change our actual armor at all. I will also take it off after this assignment so you can keep using my armor for a guideline of what is recommended. Pick up some hot pepper to obtain hot drinks. Throughout most of this locale it is extremely cold, which reduces your maximum stamina very quickly. So always make sure to have your hot drinks active. Trigger the next cutscene and fight the Beotodus till it leaves the area.
We can make a hot drink out of these peppers to beat the cold.
This monster can inflict ice blight, so use your null berries whenever necessary.
According to my notes, this monster is called Beotodus. Oh, it says its legs are its weak point. If you can get it out of the snow so you can attack it... Beotodus' weak point is its legs. Now's the time to attack them.
Yeah.
When the Beotodus inevitably leaves, hop into the nearby hot spring and crouch. Walk around until you see a yellow glowing effect around your character, and wait a few seconds to obtain the trophy Source of Relaxation.
Making you invulnerable to the climate's harsh effects. It has healing properties too.
Return from the expedition after hunting down the Beotodus to obtain the trophies The Beginning of a New Expedition and The True Hunt Begins.
Let me thank the location now that we've I've already made, but of course, the landing point.
Celiana?
Now then, I trust you. Don't let your guard down. And don't forget your cold weather.
Our first priorities are setting up base and securing that supply route.
We now have access to Master Rank Expeditions, so there are a few things to mention here. First, I will guide you through the process of capturing another rare endemic life, which will only appear on Master Rank. This creature is unique in its spawn mechanic, so let me explain how it works. Instead of a fixed spawn point, it has 3 or 4 spots in which it can appear. If you fail to capture it there, it will then cycle through these spots. I will show every spot and all the places it can show up, and you should watch the whole cycle as the bird might start at a different spot for you. The first location in the ancient forest has 3 spots that it cycles through. Note that it will always go through these spots in the same order. Capturing the Blue Diva will award you the trophy Sweet Melody. The other area in the ancient forest has four spots it cycles through. In the Wildspire Waste, there is only one cycle with three stops.
Thank you.
Here it can be very tricky to catch the bird, but you can alternatively try to snatch it out of the air as it flies around. It is straight up impossible to capture the bird here, so simply scare it away and catch it at its next destination. The final two locations are in the Coral Highlands. The first cycle has 4 stops. The 4th shown spot is another one where you cannot capture the bird and will have to chase it away first. Here, I additionally recommend using the ghillie mantle to not get annoyed by the chamois.
Ugh.
The final cycle also has four stops, with the third shown being an impossible location to catch the Blue Diva at. That concludes this episode. I will see you in the next one.
Your stamina cap has dropped. Eat some well-done steak to restore it to max.